Where have I been? What have I been doing? What is the meaning of it all? Is that a journey we all take? Imagine back when I built this chapel. Forgive me not, chapel.
This is Darby Letic Broadcasting. I've uncovered a timeless sanctuary of bliss. It is within the space.
Do you remember when?
It's been time immeasurable.
And now's when it counts.
Reflection has occurred.
I've come back.
I've had the time to understand myself, my choices.
It's been a while.
Actions. And I believe soon I will be ready to return with a better understanding of this wibblery.
And I've got it. It just took the world changing. How many of you ever saw this?
Choose to listen.
One day,
choose to believe.
Gonna be all that's left. Why are we here? Why are you here?
We are infinite.
Yeah, that's why. This is part of the whole story, isn't it? What are we doing here? So, today, I want to go ahead and touch base with y'all. Look at that. Can you see me? You can't see me. Ah. Whoa, now you can see me. Guess what? I want to go ahead and touch base and let y'all know that a lot of things are still changing. It's not getting a lot better. As a matter of fact, you might have heard about Nord Stream. What was that? Oh, yeah, that pipeline that went across from Russia. The one that Russia spent $8 billion to build. Supposedly, Russia, alert, any alerts out there, Russia supposedly blew that up. Now, they did that while we had American helicopters flying over the space. They did that while we had American vessels over the space. Somehow, we're blaming the Russians for blowing up a pipeline that can't be saved now the salt water's gone inside of it. And it's going to be dismissed. Superman can't help us here. This Superman can't do a thing about it. Nor can you. But what's that mean? Well, guess what? It's not the only storm on the horizon, kids. In case you're in Florida, you still got power, you might notice. There's another storm. And it's one hell of a storm hitting my friends. You know, my alma mater is St. Petersburg, Florida. I lived in Clearwater when I was a kid. 25 years old, I left there. Got my degree in English American Lit so I could one day grow up and write a great American novel called Wibblery and Wub. Guess what? That was a long time ago, as in 1981. I took off in a school bus after the Partridge Family concept. And I was going to go off and write my great American novel, The First Tiny House on Wheels, 1981 circa. I bought that bus for $1,500 and proceeded to fit it out, hand chiseled out all the metal out of the inside so I could insulate it because it's from Florida. Had no insulation. And I took my first tiny house on wheels, kids. In 1981, with a bachelor's degree, graduated cum laude. Hey, Ron, nice to see you. I graduated cum laude out of college with a literature degree and thought I was going to write my great American novel and headed off cross country in a bus. Little did I know in a day of no cell phones that having an address called general delivery at a post office wasn't going to get you a job. Yeah, and a lot of other problems with that. But anyway, many years later, 50 years later, I'm finally getting to write that book. I said I'd write it when I grew up. Now, guess what's wrong? The world's going to shit in a handbasket quick. So, probably, also the other problem is people don't read. So, I made some cartoons, in case you haven't been reading about them. I do cartoons now, because when I was young, man, Superman was one of my heroes. How about you? If you're in the age of cartoons, if you're in the age of comic books, man, Superman, Batman, these were your superheroes. They didn't take no jabs from anybody. That was the way it went. It was okay. We were brought up to be men, but then again, some men are just a little bit overpowered, a little too much testosterone, like Popeye and Brutus. Yeah, there was an overzealous amount of male testosterone in some of the characters of our youth. Imagine that. Yeah, kids. So, at this great late age of 67, coming up in 2 weeks, hey guys, I will be passing that magic marker that none of my family ever met. With a healthy body. I want to go ahead and say, all you guys, don't give up. Hey, Stephanie, so glad to see you here. Oh, man, that bus was so happy, except when I blew out the motor. I had $15 in my pocket, rolling down the hill into Seattle, Washington. Yeah, I had to take my motorcycle out of the back, which had fallen over and broken off the shifter, so I had to put a vice grip on the shifter to be able to go ahead and pull the clutch in, brother. And went down and found out that they lit up 15,000 people that day. Boing. 1981. So when people could look at what's going to happen right now, they don't understand. We went through a major crisis after Vietnam. When I got out of the war as a Vietnam veteran, you just didn't have a job available. So you went to college, maybe, and then hoped, and still didn't get over with. There was still a crisis. And we're about to go through that crisis, people. Three Stooges, yeah, they were great. And you can't even see them anymore because there's slapstick comedy and there's all sorts of not proper PR or whatever they call it now. Yeah, Three Stooges, I can name some others. You're right. There were some great ones. I mean, imagine seeing the Rascals on TV these days. But anyway, before I get carried away, I'm going to switch the camera around because there's a couple things I want you to know about just in case you're not paying attention. Okay, that's not one of them. I'm going to go back here. Let me shrink that screen down. By the way, that's a cool thing online if you want to look at the Book of Wibblery and Wub. And that's not what I'm bringing you here for today. One of the things is this. Look at this. This is what you call your earthquake map. Okay? Now, what's the problem with this? There's a couple of spots. That one over there, I want you to pay attention. That one over there has had 128 earthquakes in the last 72 hours, folks. Now, if you want to take a look at that, what's that look like? That looks like a pepper. And what's out there? Well, for all we know, not too much, okay? So, what's going on? Why? Why is that happening? That's a big question. I mean, we're talking about a lot of earthquakes in the middle of the ocean, all right? And that's not normal. Now, what's interesting is Iceland, which is having all that problem over here, it's just a little ways away. And there's all sorts of lava pouring out and things that are not showing up on this map anymore for some reason. And then way up here in Svalbard. Anybody ever heard of Svalbard? Svalbard. Svalbard. Look at that. It's got some over there too. So now watch this crack. See this from up here? See how this goes down through the ocean and just follows along, goes to here and hits Iceland, which is basically a bunch of volcanic lava on top of the water. And then over here is Reykjavik, and they got some, man, major earthquakes. Bad stuff. I mean, up to fives, and they're worried. Now, you get down here, this ain't supposed to happen. This is not where it's supposed to be. You're supposed to see, like, nowhere are we supposed to see that. Because that is 128. And these are not small. Some of these are in the sixes range. But what happens is, if you follow along, that crack right there, it comes right over here. Now, at the moment, you can't really see because they've got these yellow dots. We can barely see them. Right here along the New Madrid. And that goes up here. And that crack goes right up here. And it goes out here. There's one of those hidden. Look at that. Little bugger's right there. There's one hidden there. And so these are earthquakes up in Boston and all that area. Because if you have this much activity up here, way over here, okay, you have all that activity. And all that activity does what? Well, of course, it goes across and comes down. Now, look at this right offshore over there in the Mariana Islands. Another big one going on. And if you notice these, if you turn and wrap this around a globe, these are kind of opposite each other. And so that one hits and it goes around. That one hits and bounces back. And inside of a globe, these fluids, magma and stuff, are moving back and forth. Now, this is critical. See down here in the islands? Look at those. Those guys are all going off. And some of those are pretty substantial. That's not that it's that many, because it's really not. Look at that one's only like six. But I showed you 128 over there. What's important is over here, where you see this little glob? That doesn't look like a lot, but it's actually 40 earthquakes in that spot. Now, if you go up a little further up and view that, it gets to be more. But here's another troubling thing. You go over here to Hawaii, and Hawaii has 56, they're in volcanoes, but they're earthquakes. And that's in the last 72 hours. So if you look at that, those three spots, over 200 of the 1,030 that have happened in the last 3 days. So there's a lot of activity happening, but in particular, a lot of spots. Now, one other thing to note is whenever storms come in, like these hurricanes that come in here, they cause a lot of activity, and typically they cause more earthquakes. What do you know? And so there's this bash of earthquakes down here. And where does that lead? That leads up the Gulf of Mexico. Yeah, guess what? I mean, that little Gulf right there of California, excuse me. I'm over in the Gulf of Mexico. And as a matter of fact, we've been having our own fair share over here. You can't really hardly tell because they got them all turned off into yellow. But we keep about 20 or so earthquakes one day. So the problem is this. If you draw a line from here, it goes up here and catches all these, which are coming around the back. And it also, it goes around here and catches the craton. That is the big chunk of heavy ground. It goes through Austin, comes back. It actually comes down here, up through Dallas, and all the way up here, catches in New Madrid. And that's where we have our big danger, because there's a lot of pressure building up in this one little spot known as the New Madrid. And this little spot over here is why we're having earthquakes all the way over in this area. Now, what's so big about this? It's not a big deal until all of a sudden you understand. We have one of the worst hurricanes in forever ages. I used to live right over here in Tampa. Now, kids, this is some serious stuff. Okay, now, keep in mind, there's other variables going on. One of them is our planetary K. This is the amount of magnetic storms in the atmosphere. It's been very low. I've told you in the past. If this runs low, these are 3-hour increments. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, guess what, 18. We've been low, and if it stays one or under, that means when we get hit by the Schumann resonance, another factor like this monster here, those are waves of energy, but it's not just those. The global incidence map, when you look at that and you see those earthquakes are energy. That's energy bursting out of the ground. It's ultra low frequency, but it will literally affect dogs, cats. It affects your inflammatory response. It affects the amount of blood on the surface of the skin, raises the hair on animals. I mean, it's electrical. And so as it comes up bursting out of these spots all over where you see earthquakes, it can affect people as well. People don't understand that, but it does. It's energy flowing, just like a storm. Now, that storm coming in right now, that is a monster. And it's a storm that's taking over right now, coming into Miami. I mean, excuse me, St. Petersburg area, where I graduated from a long time ago. And as those kind of things come in to shore, and it's Category 4, it's tearing it up. It's making it flood. And I guarantee you, there is no place for water to go in this darn state. The highest point in the whole state is 640 feet. So as this baby comes in right here with all this pressure and storms, it's shoving all that water up into these various spots, like here and here, and it's going to raise this up all where people have been living and loving it and thinking it's all wonderful, and it's not going to be wonderful. And if it's really bad, like they say it is, it's going to go right through there and knock Orlando on its ass as well. And Orlando is where Disney World is, in case you haven't been there before. And guess what? There ain't a whole bunch to stop at a 600-foot elevation. You don't even have a high hill, hardly. I took a flying lessons down there. You get 600 feet up in the air, and you can see across the whole damn state pretty much, about 1,000 foot. 5,000 foot, you think it's a big sandbar. So it's going to cross that state like nobody's business, hit this water over here, and if it's warm enough, it's going to actually get some strength again, and then it's going to go back in and come across here and just wet down everything on this side of the mountains and cause all sorts of additional new massive, horrific, horrific rain, flooding, destruction of crops. I mean to tell you, folks, if I told you 5 times this year there's storms ahead, I've told you at least 30 times. But will anybody listen and prepare? That's the question of the day. So many of you probably are not prepared for this. You're running out to the store and boogieing out, getting some clothes, getting some food. Guess what? It's time to go. Now, I'm not getting much press on this network, this platform anymore. So I'm going to be going over here to Bastion, B-A-S-T-Y-O-N. And I'm going to be sending out a lot of stuff over there. Okay? Because they don't actually censor you and shadow you. Now, Rumble, I'm also going over there. I'm going to be joining Russell Brand, who's leaving YouTube. And I'm going to have to leave YouTube, too, because I swear I cannot do a video and get 150 people to watch it without having to be shuttered, just like Facebook. They told me again, they've now shuttered me for community standards once more. Imagine that, man. So here's the point. I'm going to these other channels because, unfortunately, some of them are controlled right now. Now, as far as this one goes, I still have a lot of stuff up on YouTube. One of my good ones is the Book of Wibblery and Wub. And that's actually the one that you saw a little bit of a little bit earlier in a chapel. Now, there's some others that you can watch that are songs. And some of the best songs, I want to say, overall, my son, of course, did one. And I would always recommend you watch it. It's called The Song of Salvage. Now, The Song of Salvage is it's a song about how do you save the world? How do you save all the materials? How do you save the valuable things that our relatives left to us so long ago? Now, there's two versions out there. And the reason I say that is one's a real campy version, and the other one my son did, which is also very good, but it's a ballad version. Now, the campy version is a Johnny Cash tune, and I can tell you, it's actually pretty darn good, but better yet, it's got some really good video. And the video on this one has us tearing down a house over a 7-day period, and you get to see women, three women in particular, doing all the work. Oops, let me see. Put it back a little bit. I think you'd like the song, because the beat's Johnny Cash. But we swapped the words out. Now, these women, this was 7 days. And we took down a house, 2 stories tall. It had been around for 150 years. It's a tune I'll keep on singing till I lift my nest in spell. Watch the magic happen. Those bees' nests we pulled out of there. Two of them, we saved them with the queen. Even. Look at this. Watch them hanging in a second. She was a surfer. She made that roof. Look at that. Hanging on nails. Chimney. Boom. Now, in the very end, you're going to see that last wall with a stairwell on it. Look at that. Those are skin removing tools. Makes that floor come up easy. This whole house. Look at the boards coming off the sides. 25 foot long. That floor nowadays is $7 a square foot, same as that wall. Look at that. Makes it look fast, doesn't it? These are the people that came. That young man was mentored. All these good people. That house lasted 8 days. You see me in the background, I'm still working. That was the Barth. I took it out there and stayed in it. Now we have many good tutorials. If you want to do this, there's tutorials on how to use the tools, how to do the teardown, what to watch for, how to be safe, what to watch out for. Bees, scorpions, hammers dropping on your head, stuff like that. So, I want you to go take a look if you can, because this is a way to actually see how to do it, but also do it to music. There's scorpions. Anybody like scorpions? There's about 13 in that nest. Yeah, that makes you want to rush out there and do it, doesn't it? Now, those shingles are actually valuable, those old shingles. Not the ones on the outside there, but the other wooden ones. Beadboard, $7 a square foot, pulled off right. Now, imagine, this entire house was $3,200 I paid for it. And then took it all down because it had to come down. Part of the lessons. Oh, we got so much rain. The day we started off was crazy. Oh yeah, be careful of the chemicals. Some of those like chlordane and things like that. You don't want to break the bottle. You want to be careful. Very careful. This teaches you how to do it. What's worth saving? Special tool techniques. Save those boards. Those cost you nowadays incredible money. That's a pure salvage living skin remover. Now tell me, does that not look a little bit easier? It shows you how to do it. Look at those boards. Those boards would cost you $8 a piece. Cheesy new ones. Look at that. What a young guy. That was 10 years ago. Silverfish are a problem. They're just hard to kill. So you want to go ahead and make sure you kill those off before you put them in the house. Boom. And I'm singing very well. On the paint, when you see that, it looks like it's a zebra on there. That's actually milk paint. These guys are taking the bees out of the wall. Their bee suits on. I got over my fear of bees on that amazing capture of the queen and all the whole family. There's a really good set of seminars that are online for free to teach you how to do this. They're all called the El Campo Expedition. Look at that, a vacuum cleaner. Thousands. Big old nests. Literally, hanging on a nail. Freaks me out. I hope that's not too loud. Yeah, I know. Sorry about that. But anyway. Okay, guys, that was pretty cool, wasn't it? That teaches you all how to do it. Look at all the salvage. If you look at nowadays, that a 2x4 like that could cost you $25, $30. Those are stacks of 2x4s. Those boards, the long ones, are longleaf pine, 1x12s. All that just looked like a piece of crap when we started. That was worth probably today, single boards on there are worth over $200 a piece off the outside of that. At the night, we all rested. And I spent the 8th day out there by myself.
That was the one-year anniversary, or I should say deathversary, after my son passed away in France. It was a spiritual experience to take down a house with so much history. Yeah, he passed away. Oh, man. So, kids, what I want you to always think about is that we have to salvage everything we can. You know, we have the opportunity in life to have so many things at our fingertips, and yet we don't always take advantage of it. Sometimes we just go ahead and waste it. And in terms of a house, after a storm, people tear them down. Don't tear those storm-ridden houses down. Tell the insurance company, take a hike. Because all those can be turned into what you're seeing right here. We're about to see all these storms hit Florida. We're about to see them go up through all these states. Please, I want you to think about this. This is the version my son did. He was only 23 years old. He created this with what would now be considered antiquated equipment. Produced it himself, taught himself how to play guitar, taught himself how to play harmonica, and created this for me before he went on his great journey as a musician off to Paris, France, where I asked him, begged him not to go. He had premonitions, but he went. So after he got back, no, he didn't. But after he got back, I learned how to go ahead and create a video, took editing, and learned how to make this so that I could have his song online forever. Nobody else would do it. They said, not a good enough song. Poorly produced. But you know what? It was a beautiful song. So, I'm spending today with a little bit extra time sharing with you what I believe now in case it ever goes black outside. If you want some sort of inspiration, that was an artist studio. She still owns that today, many years later. The Homesteader. Beautiful thing. Went up to McKinney, Texas. Gorgeous. These are all houses I built out of salvage to go ahead and prove it could be done. 95% American-made salvage materials. And then I had to have new nails, new screws. I used new wiring because I had to. And nowadays I would use very little AC, alternating current in the house. It's not good for you. Some of these, like that house, we had to lift it up 3 times with a crane just to get to where it had to go. This was while my son was lost in Paris. I knew not where he went. So I delivered 3 things. We had to pick that house up with the trailer and everything because the corners were so hard. And then we lifted it up over the treetops and dropped it in. And it looked like it had been there forever when we opened it up. That's, again, another one out in Texas. Gorgeous houses to prove. Save it. Like the song. Save all these materials, guys. Save the antiques. This was a set. A bride, a groom, and a chapel. This went up to Northern Texas. Beautiful set. I created that early on. And it was even lifted up into the air without supporting the porches. The porches actually built so they could hold. Look at that. Nothing underneath it. And it didn't fall off. Man, amazing what old wood can do. That was the chapel. That's called the Love House. It was one of the first ones I did. And actually, it sits out in a place nearby. That was the house I had my son take down, and it nearly collapsed on all the guys inside of it. This was the Painted Lady, and it went out to Round Top. Beautiful lines. Way too many colors. 6 colors. And that went out there and then unfolded to become one of the prettiest houses we did. Look at that. That was back when I was young and buff and big. Yeah. Anyway, these are great. And if you look inside, that had microwave, everything you want. And this is where we built them. Inside, underneath the roof in Manifestation Bay. And then everything folds up. The porches were hinged. You could unfold them. The kitchens were all done beautiful. That was the chapel went out to Bastrop. Beautiful. Bastrop Chapel. And it was nicknamed the Coker Chapel because that was the name of the owners. But again, I delivered that when Adam was missing in Paris. This sits out on Lazy Eight Ranch as part of a set. They ended up with 3 of them. can imagine. That folds up, a trundle bed, drop downstairs to get up to the loft, so you can actually sleep four people in that tiny little house, and a shower. And it was only like 11 by 16. That's called Big Brother, and that was next to it. That was the bigger version, and it had some incredible interiors on it. And they added so much stuff that later. That became my house, and I live in that now, out in the back. I've lived in that for 7 years. It's been the most amazing 7 years of my life. And yet it's the tiniest space. I don't have any AC, alternating current, air conditioning. I don't have running water inside. And yet I live and sleep so incredible. My bed actually floats upstairs and looks out the windows. You can see, this is one of the first houses called the Classic Ranch. That's another one of the great houses. Each of these was designed to show you all that was possible. That's in Dallas, made it into downtown Dallas. Yeah, that was called the Inner City Sanctuary. And it was a great place to have an office and a house all in one. So, I hope you enjoyed all this, guys. And I'm going to turn me back on over here, if I can find that button, and say a few things. A lot of stuff's going on. I've told you for years, if you watch my videos, the documentary even back from a long time ago, the Willy Wonka of tiny houses, I said there's a time when the global system is going to collapse. And I wanted you all to be aware and be ready. I see a lot of my friends on here. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for coming and sticking around. I've been in the doghouse, as you can imagine. You don't know who. Facebook doesn't like me anymore. They're determined to get rid of me. And I keep getting tagged. And so I'm moving over to these other sites. And I'm sorry, but I don't know that I can stay on YouTube much longer either. Because as they keep sending out this propaganda that things like Russia went and blew up their own $8 billion pipeline. And that there was no Nazis in the Ukraine and all that stuff. Well, I'm not a guy that sits back idly. I walked that cow. I actually saw. And I don't deny that there were places that you don't want to have to go in life or death. But I do want to say to you, I did that when I was like 12 years old. You can still smell in the crematories. Oh, I can't shut it off. But I want you all to know this. We don't want America to lose its freedom. We don't want America to become China. We don't want America to become Germany or any other country over in Europe for that matter. Oh my goodness. Ugh. How on earth do you stop these things? Okay, so I want you to go ahead and say, please, pay attention to what's going on. If you have a community, if you have unity and a communion of people that you share trust and honor, it's a good time to prepare in case you have to get out of Dodge and get into the country and maybe have a little community. If you don't have one yet, start thinking about it. Seriously, guys, don't put this off forever. If you don't think that time's speeding up, if you don't think that things can change overnight, I'm going to tell you right now, they already did. Bank of England is in trouble. That means the dollar, in spite of the fact that it's 113, everybody's going to say, screw you, dollar. We got lots of other ways to go. We don't need you, dollar. And the dollar's going to go, ugh! And everybody with their 401ks is going to get blown out because the stock market knows this. It's only the suckers in the stock market and the retirement funds in the stock market that's keeping it alive. And the Fed buying up stock. They shouldn't be owning it. In houses being owned by BlackRock and others, it shouldn't be owned by them. So all this artificial crap is about to crumble. And when it does, if it goes out, goes dark, goes black, because somebody decides to blow up our internet cable, because guess what? Somebody blew up their oil lines. It's going to get real deep real fast. So all those predictions, please prepare. Yes, and Marie Dyer, absolutely, please prepare. The time is now. Okay? Years and years, you've been looking at me like I'm a cook on the wall on the side of the hill, jumping up and down, saying, hey, get ready to make houses out of whatever's on hand. Don't depend on them to ship it in from China. Don't depend on Walmart. Learn how to do this. Get your screws, and you can build anything with screws. Remember, the ship of salvage dreams on top of Miracle Mountain was built with nothing but screws. No nails. You can put them in. You can take them back out again. At one time, nails were so valuable in Texas, people would burn their house down so they could gather their nails up so they could build another house down the road. They could find more trees. They couldn't find fasteners. Buy good fasteners. Torx head screws. And use them on old wood. And you can take the wood down. You can take the fasteners out. You can pack a house and you can go. I taught how to move tiny houses. I taught how to build trailers out of anything to do it.
I taught how to put communities together. I've taught all this. It's online. Please, before you lose it, go out there and pay attention to some of this stuff because very few people have watched it all. Okay, I've got another site called tinytexashouses.substack.com. I publish on there. There's articles. You can download it with pictures. I've tried to give everybody as much, not charged anything, by the way. It costs you nothing to go to that library. It's the largest library with articles, with titles you won't understand until you go ahead and open them up, that tell you how to do all this stuff. How to look for community. How to get a trustable community. How not to build houses that'll make you sick. How to stay healthy. How, even though you're thin and skinny, at least you're going to go be muscular and lean and fast. So you can get out of the way. So when the bear comes to eat somebody, he doesn't eat you. He eats that old fat guy behind you that can't make it anywhere. And if you're running down the road and you need to hide, they'll be looking for the guy over there wheezing and coughing because he can't run very far. He's got so much damn weaponry on him. He's so tired he can't even shoot straight because he's going wheezing. He's got a lot of good weaponry. Whoever gets him, man, he's got himself a lot of good weaponry as soon as he shoots him and takes it off of him. That's the sad part. So please think better than that. How can we make this better? How can we find peace? How can we establish communities? How can we thrive once the crazy people get toasted? Because they're going to toast themselves. So, please. Okay? I'm a pacifist at heart. But at some point, be prepared to protect your family. Jesus said in Leviticus, if you don't own a sword, sell your robe and buy a sword. That was the gun of the time. Now, I'm okay with swords. I like swords. I love swords. But problem is, they're not damn bit of good against a 9mm or a 12-gauge shotgun. Or an AR or anything. What you need is you need to have an AR or something to shoot back at them with. So, these are one of the reasons I can't stay on these channels anymore, is because they don't like me saying things like that. I have tiny houses, but that doesn't mean I don't have a good-sized gun to defend it with. And hunt with. And if you're hunting wild boar, you better be able to shoot a bunch of them in a hurry, because if they attack you, they will eat you in Texas. If you don't believe me, just search Died by Wild Boar. It's sad. It's not a good way to go. They are not kind to your dogs or anything else. But this in mind, there are predators everywhere. Human predators right now are the bigger problem. Please be aware. They do not make war equipment without planning on making a profit. And each one that sells it to this side has the other guy selling it to the other side. So it's kind of like, look, you better buy this or else they're going to kick your ass. And so we've sent over there how many billions upon billions upon billions of dollars to the Ukraine for weaponry to kill people, to make people here rich who own that stock in those companies, Carlisle Industries, which was actually run by Mr. Bush, our ex-president, and Mr. Cheney, Halliburton, the unbid contract for the war, all that stuff. So please pay attention to all this in the past. I've gone over this in so many videos that nobody gets to see because they're all censored. You can't imagine why, can you? Please, as one of the elders, I've become that now, you know. At 67, I'm getting up there into the older guys group. Pay attention, kids. It ain't TV. No. It ain't no movie. No. And if you get drafted, it ain't no fun. We haven't drafted anybody since Vietnam. If we do, it's going to be one hellacious wake-up call for the Army, for all of them trying to integrate these kids in. You bunch of marshmallows, kids. You don't want to hear it, but I'm going to tell you what. We had kids grew up on a ranch. We had kids grew up working like me from 12 years old on, pushing wheelbarrow, anything you could to make a living, make some money, pay for your clothes, pay for just school. Yeah. New kids nowadays, you got no chance. They're going to wipe you up, man. I wouldn't want to put you out there as my army for nothing. I'm sorry, kids. And when I say kids, what do I mean? I mean, pretty much 35 and under. 40. And sadly, between 40 and 65, oh my God, you got this. Go to a Walmart. Go to any restaurant these days that allows you to eat all you can eat. Take care of your vessel first, guys. You can build the biggest house and carry the biggest gun in the world, but if you don't take care of your body, it ain't gonna do you shit when you get sick. Healthy, healthy, healthy starts from the beginning inside. Train your vessel. It's the miracle. If you don't have this miracle operating at high speed full, you don't produce the mental capacity when you get older. You'll lose it. If you take care of yourself, you produce mature neurons that operate at 10 to 100 times the speed of the juvenile neurons and the ganglia that have 11 outputs instead of just 3, so you can actually communicate all through your brain. And then you learn you can do more than brain think. You can actually think with your eyes and tell somebody something with your eyes or the tone of your voice or perhaps just the whole telepathy to the ones you love. All these things we didn't believe were possible, they're possible. Remote viewing, just look at CIA. You want to know about it? Yeah, you can see what's happening someplace else. You want to go ahead and see about the future of the past? It's possible if you can dare see it. If you dare look. But will you see the truth, or will you see some sort of... That's the trick, isn't it? Now, what are you seeing right now? What is your perspicuity? What is the acuity of your perspective? If it's good, your gut's going, instincts, whoa, man, I'm going to prepare. And your heart's going, man, I feel so sorry for all those people that are not preparing, but you know what? There's only so much time to help, and then you can't. You got to be the light. You got to be the guide. You got to be the example, because then they're going to see you and follow. But if you just yell at them and tell them, get over there, go, 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 and you're the fat slob at the back of the line, they're going to tell you, what? You ain't going to do nothing. You going to make us do it? You going to make us go fight your war? You going to make us go out there and kill ourselves for your cause to make you richer? It ain't going to happen this time around. No. We did that in Vietnam. We did that in Iraq. We did that for Kuwait, because the Bushes own the oil on the little island on the far side of it. We've done this too many times, guys. We cannot go and get ourselves in another war. America, us Americans do not need to do that. We, all the eyes together, do not need to go to war again. Nor does anybody else. Don't let our leaders take us there. Please. I watched this happen in Iraq. This false story bullshit. And all you kids haven't been to war. You don't want to go to war. My daddy spent 2 terms in Vietnam. Thank God you haven't had to go. My friends died. Stop! Now, pay attention. The storms are not just on land. They're financial. They're global. They're political. And I said in the beginning of the year, beware of the storms, and now October. Red October's coming. That means it's going to be bloody. Full moon coming. A lot of truths come out. Please, all you LERTS, all the people that are alert, all you LERTS, go out there and share with the people you love. And they're going to say, hey, you crazy? And say, yeah, look at the evidence. Look at the earthquakes. Look at the resonance in the planet. Look at the strikes. Look at the hurricanes. These are not normal, kids. The earth changed its axis. It's tilted a different axis. The moon is rolling every night. If you're not paying attention to the moon and you don't understand that it's no longer just moving left to right, it is now rolling 180 degrees because the earth has changed its axis. And when the earth changes its axis of tilt, it changes the way everything heats. It changes the way all the winds flow, and it takes some time to catch up. Lots of shit's going on for the people that don't understand it, don't study it, like I do, several hours a day, years and years on end. I love it. Not everybody does. What I try to do is communicate to you in a more simpler language. Flat Earth is a, well, that's an interesting story. It's a great conversation, but frankly, right now, I can't buy it. I've been up in the air. I've had flying lessons. I've taken a plane up in the air. Sorry. Doesn't work for me. But I love the argument. I love the discussion of it. And there are ways that it could work to some degree. But again, it's all a damn illusion. It's all nothing but a giant hologram, and we're basically all air. We're operating inside of a gelatinous shell. It's a membrane that receives our spirit and operates. It's a vessel. It's a machine. Spirit is not the machine, guys. If you think spirit is a machine, you think I am, what you're looking at is me. It is what I express me as. It's epigenetics. It's how you use your genes to express yourself. You can be cancer prone, but it doesn't mean you gotta get cancer. It means you're gonna express yourself in a certain way. As I choose to age, I choose to keep my hair. I choose not to bald. I choose all these things because I got over believing I had to get older. After my son passed away at 55, I got younger again. 55 years of scoliosis and broken back, I got over that. I can do things I never could do all my life with no pain. You have to believe, first and foremost, believe you are a vessel of God, a spark of God manifested, thought of a God's thought as part of a plan that I didn't believe existed all my life until my son passed away and I had premonitions and it happened and then I went, ah! Shit. It can't happen. You can't have prophecy come true unless there's a plan. And if there's a plan, somebody's smarter than me, this body me, the M.I.I. me and Wibbly and Wub that I'm here to give everybody to bring as a story, the cartoons I'm writing now. That's why I'm here. It took me 50 years to get to the point that I can write this stuff before I lie. Go on my way. Everybody has a ticker. Everybody has a time. please, make your time valuable. If you're an elder, we have babies on the way through the fallopian tubes. These are fresh babies that are going to make it thanks to the fact that there's no abortion to stop them. My mother's favorite joke, as I've said before, was if abortions were retroactive, I wouldn't exist. And she made that joke into my teens to her friends and laughed casually. It was funny to her. But she was also serious, because she said that without any humor when the friends weren't around. Too many kids get brought up not being wanted. We're an opportunity in our hands. If we can create tiny villages where we can raise children, get the mothers in there and make sure they have a healthy pregnancy. And if they want to leave the child behind, they can leave that to be raised by a village of musicians, of gardeners, of people that can teach those children, raise them properly and teach them skills so that they can go on and perhaps be our leaders in 30, 40 years, being brought up by a loving family instead of stuck in front of a TV in a child seat while all the partying family behind them with the speakers on and stuff ignores them through most of their youth. We have a serious problem my generation in their 60s caused through the Spock and other things that we did. They did not teach discipline, did not teach consequence, did not teach and continue to teach analog thinking and storing memory. I had my first cyber cafe in 1995. And I had no idea what the cyber cafe, what it would lead to, all these things. And what it's led to is kids not storing anything in their brains and having digital memory where you can stick in anything into that slot and they'll accept it as long as it says Google, as long as it says Wikipedia, as long as it's some digital fact, and they will throw away reality before they will accept logic and philosophy and fact. So, we need to raise a new generation. And the only people going to do a job of that is going to be the elders who learned how to think the other way. And by elders, I mean 40 years old and up are the last of the analog thinkers. Unless you were brought up outside the computers, outside of the cell phones, you're a digital thinker if you think with digital, fill in the blank. But if you're an analog thinker, you can create things in your mind, be an abstract thinker, have an amazing imagination, also things you can do with a certain thinking mechanism that develops in those first 7 years. We need to go back to raising children where they use the first 7 years of their brain to develop it. And then, once they learn to question everything, then let them go out into the world and drive their teachers crazy asking questions that the teachers can't answer. Like I did. Oh, they hated me in class. If they'd had the drugs when I was a kid, they'd have given them to me. But I changed schools 13 times. They could never quite nail me down. Yeah, there's good and bad to that. But for the moment, the good is I learned how to adapt. The great is I learned how to learn. And you need to learn how to learn accurately. Because if you learn vaguely, you will remember vaguely. And too many kids and people nowadays have vague memory. That means they did not learn what they needed to learn with detail. So practice your speed reading. Practice your speed learning. Practice teaching children to do that instead of going to their computers and going to their cell phones. It is the death of memory in the human mind to depend on a cell phone instead. And if you don't believe it, I'm one of those people who can't remember phone numbers anymore. Why? Because I got a cell phone. Why would I do that? My cell phone remembers everything for me. So, I'm going to get off. Hey, Ron. I'm going to get out of here. I'm going to say all you guys, CJ, thank you so much for coming. And I had actually quite a big turnout for a rarity because normally I'm totally... nixed from even telling anybody I'm on. I'm not sure why. I don't swear. I don't say any bad things. I sometimes say political things, and that's what I got in trouble for, speaking about the guy that has to have a bib on to be able to talk. You know, I got in trouble for that. And talk about people that make cameo appearances on the stage and actually don't say anything, don't do anything. Well, perhaps off the stage, but not on the stage. And so, I gotta say, it doesn't matter, honestly. Either puppet gets in charge, it's not going to make a big difference. We're going to war. We're going to see changes. It doesn't matter who's in charge. In case you even figured that out. It's not the puppets, it's the puppeteers. And unfortunately, most of you don't know the names of the puppeteers. The pursuers and all the others, you don't know that. It's not for us to know. We only know about the puppets. The characters, the faces. Just like the one you see. So, signing off as Superman of the salvage world. And I want to thank everybody. Please go out there and share. Be alert. Go out there and tell everybody, hey, if you ain't got ready yet, I'll give you another good reason. Pipeline just blew up, and it wasn't Russia. That's a good reason. Why? Because there's going to be retaliation. I mean, would you not retaliate? Especially when the rest of the world figures out that they're going to freeze their asses off because the U.S. might have been the one that blew up the pipeline that would have been their only way to get out of having no heating fuel for the winter. It's gone. Even if Russia wanted to be nice and turn it on, it's gone. And there's a man that said a while back that if they went into Ukraine, then Nord Stream would be no more. If you haven't heard that man say that, you need to go online and listen, because I'm so sad. The world's going to hear that. As an American whose son was killed in Paris, France, by the children of our bombs, whose parents have been killed, whose brothers and sisters have been killed. My son was innocent. He wasn't in the military. But he went into those slums where they lived in Paris. And he died in the river. There. Please. We don't need to go to war again. Pay attention. The storm is not on our shores yet. The hurricane is nothing. The earthquake's yet to come. They're nothing. War on our soil. Nobody here has any idea. Please. Let's stop this before it gets any further. Pelosi and all these warmongers making riches off of this. We've got to have transparency. We need to have tribunals. We need to get this taken out. And I may lose my space on this station because of this, because I said all this stuff today. But tell you what, it's worth it. Please.